Give me a kiss.
Bad bitches only. Baby, you got it coming, put that pussy on me. Up top, stop talking like I'm the homie. Baby, you know I'm too poppin' to be the homie. You finna run me that pussy when I come back home. And when I hit it, you finna.
And action. Some of y'all know, because I know I think majority of the subscribers I got, the little subscribers I do got, is family. But her grandma and my grandma are sisters. Her dad and my mom are our first cousins.
Yeah, so we found for us to be close.
And you wanna know something? I'm sure we probably seen each other when we were younger, but I lived in Mississippi for like 3 years. And when I came back after my grandma had passed away, that's when I seen this little ugly thing right here.
Girl, let me tell y'all.
Girl, don't say nothing crazy.
It's crazy. This girl was speaking so country. Girl.
Speaking that country.
We used to be like, say it again. What'd you say? One more time. Oh my God, it was so funny. Then I was like, oh my God. Like, I love her.
We started getting like close and stuff. And then one summer, she was living with one of her aunts, which is my cousin. And I stayed with them for like the summer. And that's when me and her got like real close, extra close. Yes. We would like sing every day. We would talk about our dreams and what yes. we want to do and stuff like that.
My aunt used to always be like, okay, come sing this song. Come sing this song, y'all. Mm-hmm. Like if people over or whatever, she just always have us singing. So that was our thing.
Yeah. So that kind of made us get even more close. Cause like, we like the same stuff.
Mm-hmm.
And we
give each other advice all the time, even when we were younger. Mm-hmm. Sometimes she don't listen, but.
I'll listen now. Yeah. I ain't used to listen back then. Y'all listen now?
Yeah, you listen now. Well, yeah. Sometimes you still would be like, okay, should I? Okay. And then if I say no, you'd be like, should I text? And I say no. And you'd be like, but I had text. And I'm like, why didn't I just tell you, sis? No. But you do it anyway, but it's okay. It's getting better.
But eventually, she moved to Georgia. How old were you when you moved to Georgia?
I was 23. I had just turned 23. And I'm about to be 28 now, so.
Dang, so you been here for almost 5 years?
No, that's almost 6.
Oh, wait. Okay. Really?
Yeah, mm-hmm. Dang,
I didn't know
that. Wait, really? Oh yeah, you're right.
Okay.
5 years.
She's been here almost 5 years.
Yeah.
And me, I've been here almost 3. So yeah, that's about right.
Mm-hmm.
Cause by the time I came here, you had been here for about a little 2 years.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. But anywho, she had moved here. I remember the day she moved here too. Of course, I was still living back home in Illinois. I think I was leaving work or something. I had called you and you was like, I'm on my way to Atlanta. I was like, no! I was like, I'm gonna come visit you, girl. I would always tell her I'm gonna come visit, and I never
did. And you never did. Nobody ever did. Everybody like, I'm coming.
That's kind of how I feel now. Like, so many people be like, I'm gonna come visit you, girl. I'm gonna come see you, and don't nobody come. Like,
and then when some cousins or whatever, when they come, and they find out that we not actually in Atlanta, like the city, they're like, oh, okay, well, we gonna come see y'all, but then they don't. Cause they too busy having fun.
I mean,
like,
we
in
close.
The city. Yeah, we
just
like
30
minutes.
Yeah,
but I'm like 30 minutes out.
Now that I live here, I don't want to live in the city.
No, nobody should live. Listen, if you ain't like got like a business or anything like that, you don't need to be in the city. Because even if you got a business, like all the celebrities, everybody live outside of Atlanta. It's just mm-hmm. the city itself is popping, but.
Yeah,
you can always go to the city and go back home. Mm-hmm. Then, like, that traffic is ridiculous.
And I don't like how the roads are. It kind of reminds me of downtown St. Louis.
Ooh, it's
so
a lot of one ways.
Too much.
Yeah,
mm-hmm, too much.
One time I was I be doing deliveries sometimes for DoorDash and Uber Eats and stuff like that. One time I went down a one way, like I did not see the sign because I wear glasses and I don't have none. So. I did not see the sign that said that this is a one way. So I'm just driving and I'm like, this looks, and I seen cars coming. I was like, oh my God. Okay. So yeah, I do not drive in Atlanta, and yeah, it's too much.
But anywho, I'm
not gonna have time for that.
Fast forward, I used to always tell Misha I was gonna move here or visit her. Never did. And like I was telling y'all in my video where I talked about like my move to Atlanta and stuff like that. I was pretty much like getting tired of my like life and stuff like that, but I would call her and just be like, how is it there? Like, how is she'll just be like, girl, just come. If you gonna come, you gonna come.
Right. Period.
You will never know until you just come.
Mm-hmm.
So I ended up coming.
What'd you do first? You booked the flight.
Well, Derek was supposed to drive me.
Oh yeah.
But he ended up saying that he couldn't drive me, so I had to book a flight.
Mm-hmm.
And then when I booked the flight, that's when she knew it was real. She
right.
was so excited.
It was no turning back. I was so excited. Mm-hmm. I called my mama. I told my boyfriend at the time. Well, that wasn't my boyfriend at the time, but you know.
Oh my God. But when I finally moved here, it was like really like fun in the beginning. Mm-hmm. We tried to have fun.
Oh my God. But
But so yeah,
yeah,
we just always try to have fun. We walked around. We did a couple of things.
Mm-hmm.
We drove. She spoiled me when I got here, boo. I remember. I said she spoiled me when I first got here.
Yeah.
Cause of course I ain't had no job
and I ain't had no kids, so I love like doing for other people.
Dang. So you saying cause you got kids now you can't spoil me?
Period.
The love is
she don't love me like I love her. Okay.
My love is not there anymore.
It is there. I love you. Give me a kiss.
But yeah, it started to get a little rocky after a while.
Mm-hmm.
Because I was broke. I ain't had no job when I first moved here. I just had like a lot going on. And like I said in my video, I kind of was like taking it out on her. I mean,
but I did have an attitude too.
You did.
Mm-hmm.
You did.
A lot.
You did. You did. Of course.
Because I was just like, who is she to be getting mad at me when I didn't do that wrong? And who am I to be getting mad at her when I don't even really know her situation?
Period. Poo.
Like, I didn't understand what was going on in her head. And my mom was just like, okay, you have to listen to her. Talk to her and listen to what she's saying.
Cause y'all, when I say I was so depressed.
Yeah, and my mom said that.
When I talk about certain things in life, I don't really use that word depressed because
it's a serious matter.
It's a serious thing.
Yeah.
But when I was here and I was like going through stuff with like being broke and just not having a job or, you know, not being able to do anything. I was sitting in the house every day. I was really depressed. I was crying all the time.
And I would leave her all the time just because we was getting into it. So I didn't.
Man, I ain't go. Mm-mm.
She don't think so, but I know so.
She said, she claimed she was leaving to.
What?
She would leave me in the house all the time by myself.
I would.
Not by myself, but yeah, by myself.
But even before she, I don't know if she remembered this or not, but even before she got here, I told her, I was just like, I'm not gonna babysit you. Like, you can do your own stuff.
I ain't say like babysit me or nothing like
no,
that.
No, but I'm saying like, but I said that to you before you even got here and you was like, girl. Cause I was like, I'm not gonna babysit you. Like, you gonna do your own thing. I'm gonna do my own thing. We're gonna do stuff together and stuff like that. But the thing that made me like leave her more was only because we was clashing a lot. And that was breaking my heart because this is my favorite cousin. So I'm just like, why is this happening? You know, I don't understand it. And plus, I wasn't realizing that I was also the cause of some of the friction because I would say certain stuff and then it just wouldn't be the right time. Or I would say it and then she would take it the wrong way. Maybe I was, you know, being too insensitive or whatever. I don't know.
And it's like, I do apologize because at that time, everything was making me mad.
Yeah.
She could walk past me and breathe. And I was so upset, but at the end of the day, I'm not that type of person. And it wasn't just like, oh, I'm being mean to her. Or I'm gonna be, you know, have this attitude with her. It kind of was like, I would have had that attitude if anybody else was around me too. But it was just with her because, you know, we was like really like the only ones around each other for real.
Mm-hmm. And I can't make it no better because I was just like, I expect everybody to be positive Patty like me, you know? So I'm happy all the time. I want to share everything that I have all the time. And that's what I like about her too, is that she's that same way, but she has more of an attitude than I do.
Like, it's gotten better.
It's gotten better.
Yeah. It's gotten way better.
I don't want these fries.
They do.
They too much.
But yeah, we had an argument one time. You remember that one argument?
Girl, probably the biggest one we ever had.
Let's see if we're talking about the same
thing. Okay, go ahead.
Well, we was upstairs in the room, and we was talking about like the car situation and stuff like
that. Yeah.
Woo! Girl. I was ready to chop her neck off.
Girl, because you was saying some mean stuff, and then I was saying some mean stuff, and
I was like, you just so pressed right now. You was like, I'm not.
Right? I was like, pressed by what? Pressed for what? Like,
but that's so, one thing so I can say. Anytime me and my cousin argue, we never like put our business out on Facebook or like bash one person to another person. The most I ever did was probably like get advice from somebody, like majority of the time my mom or something like that. But you will never catch me bashing my cousin, because at the end of the day, this is my family, this is my cousin,
period.
And even though like we're blood, we're friends too, like we're true. Like cousins and friends. So
yeah,
it's gotten a lot better now.
I'm sleeping.
We had gotten into another argument though,
a big one.
It was here, and then you had sent me that long
text. Oh baby, she oh, I thought we was never gonna talk ever again.
I didn't think that.
I did, because like she was hurting my feelings. Because
okay,
go ahead, you tell it first, and then I'm a fiddle in.
They're gonna be like, what? Okay, Misha had got a piece of glass stuck in her foot on my floor.
Oh, I was so hurt.
I don't know how, like, I don't know. I've never broke glass in my room or nothing like that. So she had got a piece of glass stuck in her foot. So she on the floor, like, trying to figure out what's going on.
And I'm dramatic, y'all.
And Ava, which is her daughter, her baby daughter, she was walking and she just started crying out of nowhere. And Misha was saying that she got glass in her foot. And Misha was telling me to pick her up. But I'm the type of person, like, you know, like if y'all took driver's ed or y'all had a parent or somebody teach y'all how to drive. If they like screaming at y'all while y'all like trying to drive, y'all like all over the place, right?
Yeah, yeah.
That's how she was. She was like, Diamond, pick it up. And get. Like, she was just screaming. And I was just like, oh my God. I had somebody on the
phone.
And
she was on the phone at the same time.
I had somebody on the phone. It was just a lie. So it wasn't like I was not trying to pick up Ava. I just was like, oh my God. So she was like, I told you to pick her up. And and I'm just like,
who you talking to?
Who you yelling at? Like, I don't do that yelling stuff. She be yelling.
I do it all the time. I'm sorry.
I, like, if me and her arguing, I try to keep it at a minimum and just be like,
but this
why
is
you?
The thing.
But she always starts
her
yelling.
Her words hurt more than... She don't have to yell to hurt your feelings. Like, what she say hurts you more than yelling. And me, I'm just, like, I don't know. I'm just very sensitive. So,
I am
if you yell at, me, I'm going to be hurt. If you say something crazy to me, I'm going to be hurt. Even if you being sarcastic, but, like, funny, but sarcastic, and I don't think that is funny, that hurt me. I don't know. I'm just hurtable. But like, so the thing was, okay, she was on the phone, and I felt like, okay, if you see that your cousin that you love so much is hurt and I'm bleeding, okay, I feel like you should.
Yeah, like, I just left her there for dead.
She left me to die.
I grabbed her.
She left me to die.
Yeah, she was not bleeding that bad.
I went and grabbed her
some tissue and everything.
She did, but it was like slow. Like, she was moving like a turtle. Like, okay, well, okay, I see she bleeding. I guess I can get some tissue.
One thing I can say, not to cut you off, we argue about the dumbest
the dumbest thing.
We argue about the dumbest stuff. But yeah, go ahead.
Okay, so, yeah, so it was like she was moving so slow, and I was just like, okay, one, I don't want to get this blood on her carpet because, you know, stains are hard to come out. Anyway, point is, she was moving too slow, and the fact that she seen me bleeding, I just felt like she should have made an urgency. It wasn't urgent enough for me. I felt like she didn't really care for real, because she wasn't moving to help me. Like, it was like, okay, I guess I can get you some tissue. Girl, don't drip no blood on my floor. Like, she said little things like that that irritated me, because, like, I'm not trying. Yeah. Girl, you better not let that drip on my floor. Like, I'm not trying.
I said it in a playful way.
But that's what I'm saying. Even if it's sarcastic and I don't think that is funny, it's gonna hurt me. So that hurted me, because I'm like, I'm not trying to mess up your floor, sweetie, but I need you to help me. You know what I'm saying? She wasn't thinking like that. And she was on the phone. People don't move quick enough for me. Like, I feel like you gotta be with it, you know? And sometimes that's not always good. You don't have to just, you know, move so fast. Like, think so you can know, you know what I'm saying? Calm down so you can know what to do next. You know, I don't know. But that's neither here nor there. Those were our two most big arguments.
She sent me this long text message after we argued, after we got into it or whatever.
Girl, we're gonna save them for later. Come over there. We were supposed to be moving on from that, but okay. Let her finish her part. Okay, go ahead.
She sent me this long text message. She was pretty much just saying, like, I shouldn't be arguing with somebody all the time that I don't sleep with or
something.
Yes. She said something like that. But yeah, she was just saying, like, I think that we should just not talk for a while and da 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 da. What did I reply to you and say?
Baby, I don't know.
What did you say? I don't remember. How the heck you don't remember?
I just remember me sending you the text message, but I do remember that part because I was just like, ain't no
way. I was like, when I first seen the message, I honestly didn't read it because I'm like, she just made me mad. I ain't finna talk to her right now. But I actually did eventually open it up and read it. And, you know, the message said what it said. And I didn't reply for a little bit, but I eventually replied and I was like, hold on.
Ooh, geez, that was
kind of
off.
That was, yeah. I was like, girl, I'm about to get this new YouTube camera and we about to do these videos.
Oh, yeah, she did say that.
I ain't worried about what you're talking about. Talk to you later.
She did say, she's like, I'll see you later. I'm gonna let you know when I get the camera so we can do these videos.
Period.
And that's it. And I was like, first of all, who she thinks we're talking to?
And she gonna try to, like, not reply for a little while.
Exactly. Because I was like, who she thinks she's talking to? Like, she's
and then
me. I like people talking to me like that, though.
Girl.
Put me in my place.
No. But she eventually, we eventually started back talking and stuff like that. But,
like, be nice to me, but still put me in my place.
Yeah. We have gotten so much, like, better now. We could spend a whole day with each other without arguing.
Yeah. Ooh, 2 days in a row.
Three.
Four. A whole weekend,
bro. Like, we are so much better. Yes. We communicate.
We FaceTime every day
for hours.
Like,
we never really did that. No. And I actually love it because it's like we're kind of gaining that relationship back. Because at the end of the day, like I said, this is more than just my cousin. We're friends.
And we only got here in Georgia, so
yeah. So
yeah.
I remember one time, y'all, we got in an argument and she blocked me. I was like,
I'm quick at blocking people because I
am
like
her only family here. How she gonna block me?
I don't like
what would have happened.
I don't like, I know I would have felt so bad, but I don't like confrontation. So when people keep trying me like that, it just brings out another side of me that I don't want to come out, you know? Yeah. I don't test that side often, so yeah, pretty much at all. So I done changed. Listen, I be ready to slap people quick. At first, I used to be so calm, so sweet, so pleasant. And I'm trying to get back to that person.
But anywho, we have gotten so much better. We talk all the time. I always come to her with advice. I know she probably taught me. But
but the fact that she listen now is better. Like, I like giving advice to people who listen. Don't ask me if you ain't gonna listen.
But yes, that's pretty much it for this video. Like, yeah, we just
that was real
just,
quick.
Yeah, a real quick video. Just talk to y'all about, like, our relationship,
yeah,
and where we stand. Yeah. I know I had mentioned my cousin in one of my videos, so I'm like, okay,
I gotta bring
her to my channel.
Here we are.
Whatever. But
yeah. So stay tuned
for more videos.
Exactly.
If she ain't getting on my nerves. No, just playing. Like I said, we passed it.
Cause I'm finna thump her real quick.
We passed it now. But no, I was saying, like, we like real good at communication now. And honestly, I don't know if you kind of feel it, but I kind of feel like sometimes, like, we be saying stuff towards each other that could lead to an argument, but I kind of like back off a little bit just so.
Me too, yeah.
Like yesterday with the sandwich thing.
What sandwich thing?
The Subway sandwich.
And I was standing firm on that because I was just like, why would you not check to make sure that my sandwich is in yours?
First of all, boo.
And then you want me to go back and get it? Not happening.
I mean, it was your sandwich,
but
I had to go.
Okay, but I'm just saying. I just felt like But anyway.
But we left that alone.
But yeah, she left her. We went to Subway. They made a sandwich for her.
We wanted it all in the same bag.
And they put the chips.
They put chips, the cookies. They put everything all in the same bag except the sandwich. So I was irritated because I'm just like, I was starving.
Yeah. And I told her, I was like, just go back and get it. And she was like, I'm not going back and get it. And I'm just like, I spent my money on it. Like, go back and get it.
And I was like, listen.
So I'm not going back there. And I couldn't go back because I had to go get my hair done and stuff. But whatever. Like I said, we have moved past that stuff. We are doing a lot better. We communicate more. This is my favorite cousin. I love her. And
I love her. I'm back.
I'm about to take a nap.
No, you're not.
Oh, we got to put this desk together.
Yeah, we got to vlog.
Cousin, how we going to have enough time to do that? You got to get them at 3.
No, I don't. I said I'm not going.
Yay!
No, they going to stay at school all day. I love my babies. But when I have a little bit of free time money.
Like, we try to cherish that.
Exactly.
And them ain't even my kids. I don't even be around them all the time, but I'm like, that's cool.
Okay.
Right. All right, girl, what we finna do? But I wanna thank you guys so much for watching this video. There will be more videos to come with both of us. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. And I am going to link her channel in the description box. So make sure y'all subscribe.
Subscribe.
And yeah, we will see you guys in the next video.
Bye.